And it was a day to remember indeed. Now, from equestrian elegance to Mzansi royalty. This morning, we welcome one of South Africa's most beloved and celebrated music icons. Not only is he a singer, songwriter, and a dancer, but he's also an anthropologist and one who's made us super proud all over the world. He's a musical activist whose infectious crossover music, his vibrant blend of Western pop and African Zulu rhythms, has exploded onto the international scene and broken through barriers in his own country and all over the world. And of course, we are talking about none other than Ubaba, Johnny Clegg. Ladies and gentlemen, back in the studio again. Back in the studio again. And it's always such a privilege, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Last time we had you here, it was a bit of an emotional time for us and for all of your fans as you announced that you would be taking on your final tour.
Yes.
And you've now wrapped that up. And tell us about the experience and what that final trip was like on tour.
Well, basically, I've wrapped up the South African leg.
Yes.
It ended up with 4 shows in Port Elizabeth. Obviously the international audience is different to my home audience, mm-hmm. because my home audience has grown with me over, you know, 4 decades of music and touring here. So that the entire tour is a very bittersweet thing for me. Mm-hmm. I would like to continue, obviously, but it's not going to be possible. I then do the European leg, mm-hmm. In June, July.
Yeah.
And Australia, and that's the end of then I'm wound up.
Wow. And during the performances, are there some moments, perhaps highlights or emotional moments that stand out more than others?
Playing with my old partner, Sipho Mkunu, takes me back to the early 70s, 80s, Chuluka, and then obviously the song that my son wrote for me, which we sing together on stage, which is the next single, is also a very emotional moment for me.
Yeah.
But I think also the show is an autobiographical show, so you've got all the 4 decades of music, Johnny and Sipho, Chuluka, Savuga, and Johnny Clegg.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's a bit of a roller coaster of feelings,
yeah.
all those bands and all those memories.
Mm-hmm.
It's audio-visual as well, so you have a historical record of pictures and videos of those periods.
Yeah.
So it's a really fitting moment for me.
Yeah. What do you think you're going to miss the most about being on tour, about performing in front of your audience that has grown up with your music and loved it for so many years and has changed so many people's lives and perspective on life? What do you think you're going to miss the most about that?
Well, performing is a very intimate thing. It's connecting with an audience in a short period of time, 1.5 hours or 2 hours, and to take them out of their ordinary daily life and to elevate them into a quality space that is special, that you can connect to and share. I'm a singer, songwriter that writes about the South African experience. That's what I focus on. So, especially for South Africans who listen to what I do, I connect with them on another level, which I don't do overseas. Mm-hmm. Overseas, people just like the music or the beat or the visuals or the spectacle or whatever. So, especially in South Africa, for me, it's been a wonderful aspect of my touring. I think that, you know, I've been touring full time since 1983.
Wow.
Locally and internationally. And it's in my blood. It's something that defines me. The wonderful thing about performing is you get shaped by your performance, and you shape your audience,
mm-hmm.
And you interact with one another, and that's a very special relationship.
Yeah, we're going to talk to you a little bit later on about the one last offering you have left for us,
yes.
King of Time.
Yes,
a very appropriate title indeed, if I do say so myself, and I can't wait to hear about it. The music video that you worked on with your son, beautiful stuff, and great memories for us as fans to hold on to over the next couple of years. So thank you so much once again for joining us. Stick
thank
around,
you.
Johnny Clegg, still with us on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show. Well, from the Grammys red carpet to a Grammy-nominated artist and, of course, much beloved Ntate Johnny Clegg joining us, joined also by 3 of his favourite fans, and you're also a fan of the Frenchies.
I love them.
I'm sure they're just as glad to see you here. Now, early on, when we were talking about the fact that you had just wrapped your final tour, we also mentioned that there's a new offering, a 7-track album called King of Time.
Yes.
Tell us about the album and why you thought it appropriate to just give us something more to hold on to, especially now that we're not going to see you on stage anymore.
Well, the King of Time album is really, it's a celebration of 40 years of music. It's an idea that sometimes when you're performing live, you reach a connection with your audience where you would like to just freeze that moment forever. Mm-hmm. The song is built around a Zulu idiomatic expression, "Wolibamba ilanga lingashoni," which means grab the sun so that it doesn't set. Mm-hmm. Freeze time if you can, because it passes so quickly. And for me, this 40 years has been just a blink.
Wow.
So that's the concept around the album. And there's a whole lot of different moments in it. The song is also, it's not a concept album. Mm-hmm. Each song is discrete and is coherent in and of itself. It stands as they're all standalone singles. Mm-hmm. And there's songs, some serious songs about relations between South Africans at the moment. There's one song called "Color of My Skin." Mm-hmm. There's a song on the environment called "Ocean Earth." And there's some classic Johnny Clegg love songs crossover, but very, very modern productions.
Yeah.
So it's part of a 3-year idea that I had that I would do a final journey tour, I'd do an album, and I would do an autobiography, which is what I'm busy with now.
And I'd love to show people at home a snippet of the video from King of Time that you worked on with your son, Jaron. We'll talk a little bit about that in a second, but take a look at this.
I've been thinking about the way I think about my thinking. I have a feeling that our little boat is sinking. I don't know anymore what it is she sees in me. Maybe the promise of the man I used to be. Somewhere long ago we lost our way. Stop the clock and start again. If I could freeze the sun in the sky, I could go back in time. If I could only go back to that day, maybe we'll find our way. King of time.
We're loving it.
Thank you.
We're absolutely loving it. So how special, guys, come on. That's wow, King of Time. How special was it to work with your son Jaron on this video? You were telling me he went overseas to go study film and this is part of him plowing his skills back into your craft.
Yes, it's been an incredible time of my life where both my sons have flowered doing their various creative passions. Mm-hmm. And Jesse co-writing with me, Jaron doing the videos for me. So it's been a wonderful family moment the last sort of 18 months. My live show, 8 of the videos which we put on are all edited, shot by Jaron. Oh. And the previous video he did for me, Take My Heart Away, mm-hmm. It won 8 international awards, so he's really got his sense of balance. He's busy now with a kind of an African sci-fi feature that he's developing and scripting. So
wonderful.
It's wonderful just to see the two of them getting up and flying.
You must be so proud, and to have them work with you on this final offering. And we are incredibly privileged to have you here to talk about it. The album is available. We can get it now. Download everywhere. Music video is available. We can
Downloading.
Watch it over. We can watch it over and over again. As always, Baba Siyabonga. Cool. Thank you so much for being here, Johnny Clegg, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.